The founder of Google, American internet entrepreneur and computer scientist, Larry Page, is the creator behind the search engine that has changed the entire experience of internet usage, and finds himself on the top 10 list of the richest people in the world. Page is also the co-creator of PageRank, a search ranking algorithm used by Google. Before we continue to get ourselves acquainted with Larry Page and meet the man behind the mastermind, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and give this video a thumbs up. After the video, don't be shy to comment your opinions about Larry Page and Google. Let's go. Given a good start in life, Page has been described as a pioneer in computer science and artificial intelligence. Larry Page was born on March 26, 1973, in Lansing, Michigan, to a Jewish family. His father, Carl Victor Page Sr., had a PhD in computer science, and Larry remembered that his childhood home was filled with computers, science books, and tech magazines, something he as a small boy enjoyed. He would sit for hours, flicking through and reading all sorts of different books and magazines, diving into the world of computers and technology. His mother shared the same interest as her husband and son, and worked as an instructor in computer programming. In addition to technology, Larry Page was also interested in music, and his parents sent him to music summer camps when he was young. Page says he has thanked them several times for this, as he believes that if it would not have been for his great interest and love for music, Google would not have been born. Page means that it was through music he learned how to become aware of perfect timing, and how important it is that all parts and instruments interact with each other, for the whole machinery to run smoothly. An approach he brought with him when creating Google. Page continued his interest in computers and technology further into his teenage years and young adolescence, and in 1995 he received a bachelor's degree in computer engineering from the University of Michigan. In 1998, he earned a Master of Science degree in computer science from Stanford University. When looking for study topics in the doctoral program at Stanford University, Page considered delving into the link structure of the World Wide Web, researching telepresence, or self-driving cars. His supervisor, Terry Winograd, encouraged Page to pursue the idea of understanding and exploring the link structure of the World Wide Web. In 2008, Page said that was the best advice he has ever been given. Page began a research project on the link structure, named Page Backrub, and quite early in the startup, a colleague named Sergey Brin joined in. Together, the two co-wrote a research paper, titled The Anatomy of a Large-Scale Hypertextual Web Search Engine. The paper became one of the most downloaded scientific documents in the history of the internet at the time. In order to sort out the data that Page and Brin collected in the project, and put it on a web page, they developed an algorithm called Page Rank. This is when they realized that algorithms could be used to build a search engine that was much better than the already existing ones. The algorithm relied on a new technique that analyzed the relevance of the backlinks, connecting one web page to another. In August 1996, the first version of Backrub was made available to internet users, and in 1998, with financial help from teachers, family, and friends, Page and Brin managed to get together a few servers, and rented a garage in Menlo Park, which was the beginning of Google. The name was actually a misspelling of Page's original plan name for the company, Google, which is a mathematical term for the number 1, followed by 100 zeros, the large amount of data that the search engine was built to explore. Shortly after this, Page and Brin received a check for $100,000, which was signed out to Google Incorporated. The only problem, though, was that Google Incorporated did not yet exist, and during the 2 weeks it took from the check being written to the paperwork being done, the money could not be deposited onto any account. When Google Incorporated later was created, the first domain name Google was set. By mid-1999, when Google received a $25 million round of venture capital funding, the search engine was processing 500,000 queries per day. Activity began to explode in 2000, when Google became the client search engine for one of the web's most popular sites, Yahoo. By 2004, When Yahoo dispensed with Google services, users were searching on Google 200 million times a day. That growth only continued, and by the end of 2011, Google was handling about 3 billion searches per day. The company's name became so global that it entered the lexicon as a verb, to Google, became a common expression for searching the internet. Larry Page's management style in the company was tough, and he tried to fire all Google project managers back in 2001, with the explanation that he did not like when people without knowledge supervised people with knowledge. Page also wrote down some principles he wanted his team to use as reference. Number 1, don't delegate. Do everything you can yourself to make things go faster. Number 2, don't get in the way if you don't add value. Let the people working talk to each other while you go and do something else. Number 3, don't be a bureaucrat. Number 4, ideas are more important than age. Just because someone is junior doesn't mean they don't deserve respect and cooperation. Number 5, the worst thing you can do is stop someone from doing something by saying, no. Period. If you say no, you need to help them find a better way to get things done. Moving on. When Silicon Valley's two most prominent investors agreed to invest a total of $50 million in Google, they demanded that Larry Page step down as CEO, to make way for someone who could build a world-class management team. This led to Larry Page receiving the proposal and handing over his seat to Eric Schmidt, who took over Google's CEO role in August 2001. Even so, Page was still the head of Google in the eyes of the employees, and was therefore always the one who had the final say in all approvals. In January 2011, Page stepped back in as CEO of Google, and his two main goals was to make the managers and the company more independent, and create more collaboration between sections within the company's different levels. In August 2015, Page once again stepped down as CEO of Google, and instead became CEO of the new holding company, Alphabet Incorporated, with Google becoming a subsidiary of the group. This was done to be able to gather all the brands under the same umbrella, thus helping the brands run more smoothly and independent, in order to gain their own strength. With this reorganization, it was also possible to make it easier to disclose transparency, as you don't have to share business secrets the same way. In December 2019, Larry Page resigned from his post at Alphabet, and in a joint blog post that he wrote together with Sergey Brin, stated that when there are better people to run the company available, they did not want to stand in the way of the company's future development and progression, and therefore had decided to step to let a new fresh breeze in the company, for its own good. Larry Page is also an investor in Tesla Motors, and in renewable energy technology, and is also a strategic supporter of Opener, a project developing flying vehicles for consumer travel. Page is also the co-founder of Singularity University, a transhumanist think tank, with Google as one of the institution's corporate founders. What are your thoughts on Larry Page and Google? Comment below, hit the thumbs up button, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Thank you for watching and see you next time.